Hey guys, Theo here, and welcome to the Caffeine Zone, where we discuss everything coffee. Now, in this instant coffee series, today we are tasting Jacob's Kronum. Created in the 1895 year. Yes, I said it that way. Now, today owned by the same company as the Doe Egbert, it used to be Jacob's Doe Egbert and John Jacobs. And the one company bought the other one out. So a gigantic international company that does a phenomenal good coffee. Even though on the Jacobs side, I'm not always a fan. Slightly too intense for me. It burns my throat. But let's jump right into tasting it. Now, if you go to Holland or to Germany and you have this instant coffee, they all know a cup is 100 mils big. Ask any Dutchman. So we will be using 2.2 grams because they actually don't give us the recipe on this bottle because they know what it should be. But we will go 4.4 grams to 200 mils of water. So 2.2 per 100 grams or 100 mils. Nice and light. There we go, 4.4. Actually, a nice aroma coming from this one. Here we go, starting the timer. Remember to never use boiling water. It extracts the bitter elements way too much, and then you feel the need for milk and sugar. Start the timer and we will taste the coffee on 2 minutes. Ooh, nice crema popping off the top. Slightly less than the espresso from Nescafe, but a lot more than the classics. Very nice. Let's fast forward to 2 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes, let's give it a nice little stir, make sure that all the coffee has dissolved, and then we give it a sippity sip. Very nice aroma coming from this one, very sweet. My experience thus far with Jacobs is not the same in flavor, because it's made for the slightly more intense palate. Okay, so first, woo, man, that one is intense. Ooh. I feel it in the throat. Okay, sweetness, acidity, bitterness. And on this coffee, I'll add intensity. Sweetness, probably about a 3 out of 10. Not bad on sweetness. To acidity, a proper 8 out of 10. For sure, that's where the intensity comes in. It's really, really intense on the side of the tongue. Not a bad cup though. Bitterness, slightly on the heavy side. I'm gonna be gracious towards it. I'm gonna say 4 out of 10, but it could be a 5 on bitterness, which means milk with this would be insane. But that's actually balanced enough that I would not want to add sugar to this coffee. Now, of course, of all of the ones that you've seen, this is a freeze-dried coffee. The motion of getting this Robusta to this beautiful little crystal shaped coffee is brewing the Robusta, of course, freezing it, putting into a dryer, breaking it into all of these beautiful little crystals, putting into a humidified dried oven, and extracting all of the humidity, leaving us with a really, really quick, fast, and convenient cup of coffee that is not too bad in flavor. So if this sounds like a coffee that you would enjoy, then Jacobs is the way to go. This one is, on scale, a 3 out of 5. So this is kind of on the medium roast side. So it's not the really intense, the really strong one. But if that sounds like a coffee that you would enjoy, then this is the coffee for you. Hope you guys enjoyed this. And may you find your happy place every single cup.